He has enamel hypoplasia. So the plan for him is to deliver 10 veneers all in the same day. Since his centrals were a little lingually inclined, I don't prep too much away. And since it's mostly additive on the incisal, I don't take much away off the incisal either. But this is immediately after delivery. And he was so taken aback because he's not used to smiling. So now I think I created a monster because he's sending me selfies almost every day. This is Amir. Amir was still learning how to smile. He could not smile normally in these preoperative photos because he was so self-conscious about his teeth. So we take a closer look. He has enamel hypoplasia. Young guy, 24. He's engaged to be married later this year and really wanted to have better wedding pictures of him smiling. So you can see his preoperative condition. So the plan for him is to deliver 10 veneers all in the same day. Now, his bite is collapsed as well. So what we do is I milled out those shells using biotemp bridges. So we went ahead and bonded those in first. I don't have a wax up from the lab. So what I do is a chair side mock-up, flowable composite, and build the incisal, bring the facial surface more facial, and define the midline. Once I have the midline incisal edge position, I usually will evaluate the incisal edge position with the patient at rest. We're looking for 2 to 3 millimeters of incisal display with the patient at rest. That's usually what I use to define the incisal position for the patient. Once I establish those three critical components at the centrals, we scan that in as our pre-op model, pre-treatment model. That's gonna help guide all of the designs. Once we get our pre-treatment model of the upper, lower, now I'm gonna go through and improve the gingival architecture using our water lays. Make sure our symmetry is on. And then once I change the gingival architecture, now we're gonna prep through. So large round end tapered diamond. I'm just really just trying to establish a gingival chamfered margin. Since his centrals were a little lingually inclined, I don't prep too much away. And since it's mostly additive on the incisal, I don't take much away off the incisal either. Once the preps are done, using our Medit, scanning this in. This green model, it's called a reliability scan or reliability map. My assistants were always scanning. Every time they scan, I would see this green model. I didn't really know what it was, but it's so cool. Now what I understand is whenever you use this scan, there's color, there's stone, and this reliability map, this bright green is indicating a very accurate data set. So you basically rotate and position. You see red and orange is like low data. Just keep passing over the zone, rotate enough so that you can fill all of those areas in and convert the model into a bright green model. Of course, we finish off with the bite scan and the patient is at their new vertical with those biotemp bridges in the posterior. So with a full arch scan, you can take a couple different occlusal or bite registration scans from each side of the patient. And then once we transfer that into our chairside design software, I'm using the pre-op scan of that chairside mockup to then position, there's embedded libraries in the design software. I position 8 and 9 first, pretty even with the angle, size, position of that mockup that I created. And then from there, I don't need the position of the laterals. I just base it entirely off of 8 and 9. So then I drop the laterals in, I drop the canines in, and so on. And so I just check from side to side, making sure everything flows, having fun. In the software, you can see there's a grid feature where you can visualize and just check for symmetry. You can see the finish lines. Yes, I'm bringing it a little more facial, but that is kind of what we do. We're disguising the original position of the teeth. So using the tools, guiding, once I guide the library teeth into the correct position, then I use that freeform feature, establish the right emergence profile. I create the right contact areas. I check it from this incisal, or rather apical view, just making sure all of the designs flow well with one another. You want to ensure that you check it from as many different views as you can, but obviously starting from the facial, and then I work from lateral views. For this case, I actually didn't pack cord. Now, I showed a bunch of cord cases earlier, but sometimes when I do design a lot of my anterior cases, when I do pack cord, when we shift that soft tissue area, we drop the papilla, sometimes I get a little unsure of where to position the emergence, how much space. If there are any black triangles, I kind of exacerbate those issues, sometimes end up with over-contoured zones. So before we scan it in, I make sure there's no tissue tags, all the finish lines are visible. And for this case, I just prep the margins equigingivally. And then we mill these out in camouflage again. You saw that block, this is a camouflage bleach shade. We have one bleach shade that is super white, but it actually matched his lower hypoplasia appearance teeth really, really well. So for these veneers, always go through a try-in process. We're using try-in gel to just check the fit, check the aesthetics, confirm the fit. And then now we're gonna go through our bonding protocol. We drop our phosphoric acid on, spread it out. And of course, after you etch the teeth, the bleeding starts again. So that's fine. If that happens, I just go through a hemostatic process again, make sure we flush off as well as we can, isolate. And I'm using, for this case, for all veneer cases, I use a light cured aesthetic resin. So for this case, I use Variolink aesthetic, or Variolink veneer. I think it's Variolink aesthetic, right? Variolink. And there's a warm plus. Many of these aesthetic resins come in different chromas, so I used the warmest one because I wanted a little bit, because this bleach shade is super bright. So I wanted a little bit of warmth coming through. Usually I use kind of a mixture of clear and white, but this is immediately after delivery. And he was so taken aback because he's not used to smiling. So now I think I created a monster because he's sending me selfies almost every day. What's even better, the night we did this, he called his fiance, who was in India, to show her for the first time. So I told him, when he shows her, you please record it and tell by her reaction that she was pretty happy.